Now, as Jesus and his disciples went on their way, he entered a certain village where a woman named Martha welcomed him into her home. She had a sister named Mary who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to what he was saying. But Martha was distracted by her many tasks, so she came to him and asked, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to do all the work by myself? Tell her then to help me." But the Lord answered her, "Martha, Martha, you are worried and distracted by many things. There is even only one. Mary has chosen the better part, which will not be taken away from her." The Gospel of the Lord.
Distracted about many things, all these other thoughts that she's
They wanted to have a seat so they could stick around and fester. Jesus isn't pitting the two sisters' choices against each other. He's concerned that Martha's loving gift, her loving act, was marred by her distracted, irritated thoughts. This story is deeply significant to us. Like Martha, we all have unhealthy, unhelpful thoughts that every day cross the doorstep of our hearts. Jealousy and anger, temptation and sinfulness, selfishness, fear and prejudice, lust and laziness, our defensiveness, our ego that says we are who we are and no one can tell us different, our inability to face our mistakes and our sin, our unwillingness to hear anyone else's point of view, all of these drives up out of our broken nature, out of our emotional lives, even from the outside. But if these become house guests, if these stay at the table of our hearts, there is no room for any that are healthy, no seats for any who would give us life. We can't control when these thoughts, when these things show up. But Jesus says we don't have to invite them in. Offer them a seat. Give them something to eat and to drink. We have choices. Whether to invite them in or let them pass by. Whether to nurture and feed them or tell them that our cupboard is bare and there's just nothing for them here. When we copy Martha and invite Christ in while showing these other things the door, we find love. Martha shows us that it matters whom we invite into our hearts. And we want to invite those things and those people to the table of our hearts who will give life, starting with Christ Jesus. Because Jesus is sitting at her table, Jesus can love Martha into a new way of being, which is exactly what he will do for us when we invite him in. When Christ is sitting at the table of our hearts, he brings in the life-giving love of God. There is no life that makes any sense to any of us apart from Christ Jesus bearing the love of God in us, centering our lives, focusing our actions, giving us peace. But when Christ comes in, he's also going to point out those things that are distracting us, that we've let into our lives that lead to death. He's going to sit at our table and look across it and say, are you sure you want that in here? Is inviting that into your life a good thing for you? It had to hurt Martha deeply to hear Christ's criticisms. But by letting go of her distractions and facing them, she was able to find a path to deeper life in Christ, which we see in her later at the graveside of her brother. Like Martha, this isn't going to be easy for us. It might even feel like dying to let go of these house guests that we've become awfully attached to. But it's also going to be the only way that leads to life. This is the way that the world is going to be healed. All of these things that overwhelm us, that threaten us, racism, injustice, poverty, and war, hatred, and violence, all of these things begin to end when one person's heart begins to change. When the thoughts and feelings and opinions that lead to such destruction are shown the door, and Christ Jesus comes in with the love of God and with a good broom to keep that house clean. One person by one person. This is how God intends to heal the world. But there is deeper mystery. The true first invitation is given to us. We meet the Triune God in Christ Jesus, who invites us into life, into grace, into joy. face to face in baptism, we are washed clean of these resentments and hostilities and irritations and sins and prejudices and frustrations, all these house guests that keep trying to make room in our hearts. This is mystery. When we invite Christ into our hearts, we find Christ there already, inviting us further into the life of God, deeper into the love that holds all things together. This is mystery. That in facing death for us, Christ Jesus has taken away the power of all these things that seem to control us beyond our ability to do anything. Those things so hard to disinvite. Those things we wish we could show the door to. This is mystery. In taking away their power, Christ Jesus is, as Paul says, reconciling the whole world back into the life and love of God. This is the mystery of life in Christ. That in Christ coming into our lives, we are utterly changed. And this is how one changed heart at a time, one changed life at a time, from Martha to us, to the world, that all things will be made whole and well in God's love. We may return.